Welcome. In this video, we're going to be looking at the complete note format and form reorder options in DrChrono and the differences between the two. We're going to look at complete note format first. Now, complete note format changes the order that the final note is rendered. I'm going to hit preview note here. And after this loads, I'll go ahead and scroll through the note here. And at the bottom, I can see I have all my sections here. I have my check-in information. And if, for example, I want that at the beginning of the note, I can change that with the complete note format. So in order to do that, I'm going to go to clinical and then go down to complete note format. And once I'm here, I can drag and drop the sections to the order that I want. So I'm going to go down here and grab the on-patient additional info information and put that at the top. And you could drag these into any order that you would like for your final note. And I'm going to put the reasons for visits next. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit save. Now I'll go back to my clinical note. And once I'm there, I'm just going to hit preview note again to refresh everything. And you can see the check-in information is now at the top of the note. So it's pretty easy to rearrange the order of your note to make it fit your needs. Let's take a quick look at form reorder. Form reorder is a similar process to complete note format, but what form reorder does is it puts the forms under the additional tab in the order that you would like them to appear. So we'll go to clinical and then form reorder. And similarly, we can drag and drop these forms into the order that we would like. So I'm going to take trigger point injection, lumbar facet, and then I'm going to grab cervical spine just for fun here, and I'm going to go down and hit save. Now when I go back to my clinical note here, I'm just going to refresh the page real quick and then go back to the additional tab. And now the forms are in the order that I would like them to be. And this will also impact the iPad as well. So on the iPad, just to look at this real quick side by side, I'm going to go start my visit and click the menu here to see my forms under the additional tab. So if I want to change these, it's going to be the same process, and this will change it on the iPad and on the web. So I'm going to just drag and drop a couple examples here real quick and then save. And then once this is done, I'm going to go ahead and refresh on the iPad. And we can see the forms are now in the order that I would like. So the changes impact both platforms. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.